Jams is presented by Lawrence Technological University. Possible is everything. Sarah Chevrolet, the low payment people. Visit us at lowpayment.cars. Meijer, your destination for sporting goods and equipment. And Hungry Howie's Dough Raiser. Your next fundraiser comes with flavored crust.
I'm Lauren Plantin. I want to welcome you inside the halls of what is Yellow Flag Productions, the home of the State Champs Sports Network. Welcome to show 500 in State Champs history. We're presented by Lawrence Tech. It's a finals weekend, so lots of state champs to crown in this show, but that's not all.
I'm Stephanie Funkhauser, and as a part of the second generation of state champs, I love how far we've come over the past few years. But it's fun to take a look back at how it all began. It's always been a family affair.
We've got a few surprises coming up, including the five most memorable state championship moments in state champs history.
But most of all, we've got selected playoff highlights from every sport across the state. We start with baseball. Ryan Slocum kicks it off.
Division 1 pre-districts, 5th-ranked Bay City Western taking on number 6 Mount Pleasant. Oilers batting in the bottom of the first, Obi Rickumstrick knocks one back up the middle. That brings in Noah Ingram to even it up at one apiece. The Warriors move back in front in the third. Hunter Buzkowski hits Brady Lepick with the bases loaded. Tyler Snover scores to make it a 3-2 ball game. The Oilers answer again. Max Trucks grounds to first. Cody Freed throws it home, but it's Ingram with a great slide to tie it up. Western jumps back in front in the fifth. It's Lepick with the soft liner to right. That brings in the go-ahead run, and the Warriors don't look back. Bay City Western eliminates Mount Pleasant 7-3. Now let's continue our roundup with Lauren.
Thanks, Ryan, my friend. We make our way to the Clearbrook Golf Club in Saugatuck for a Division II Boys Golf Regional. Three schools qualify to make it to states next week, and always one of the teams in the mix from the greater Grand Rapids area, Kenowa Hills. Leading the way on this day, the junior Ryan Tenbrink. Ryan shot a 73, including this birdie, to take medalist honors. Kenowa Hills took third and are moving on. The OK Green Champs Byron Center are another team that punched their ticket. They've got a trio of senior leadership, including Grant Huizinga. The birdie on 18, Bulldogs finished runners-up. And the champs are some first-timers. With the district title already on their scorecards, Otsego finished a stroke better than Byron Center. Tyler Raymond shot a 75, and these Bulldogs win their first D2 regional title in school history. Good luck at state. To girls soccer, Division 1 district finale. Berkeley taking on Troy Athens. This game played at Royal Oak High School. We picked this game up early in the second half. No score. Two juniors pairing up to put the Hawks on the board. Lindsay Boots to Ashley Leonard, and she does the rest. 15th goal of the season. The Redhawks added some insurance with 16 minutes to go. Long free kick. Ball's loose. There's the junior midfielder, Aubrey Wachowski. Her second goal in as many games. Troy Athens blanks Berkeley 2-0. Another district championship celebration for the Redhawks. Let's go north now, way north to the Upper Peninsula, as we introduce Sam Ali for highlights of the UP Golf and Tennis State Finals.
Thanks, Lauren. It was a windy day at the Wawanawin Country Club for the D1 UP Golf Finals. Houghton's Gunnar Stein was battling the elements at the fourth hole. His putt would stop just a few inches away from the hole. He would settle for par as he finished the day shooting a 74 to lead the Gremlins to a UP state title. Who had the top score, you ask? Nagani's Carter Mason, who sinks this putt at 18 to give him an even 72 for the day. On the girls' side, one of the few left-handed golfers was Escanaba's Paxton Johnson. The wind kept her from a birdie here, so she would settle for par, finishing with the top score of 86 to help the Eskimos get their first state title since 1998. On to boys' tennis now for the Division I finals in Nagani. The hosts were determined to put on a good show for the home crowd. Number 2 singles here, Eric Hurst near side, Alex Shanks of Kingsford far side. The action goes back and forth until Shanks misplays the ball and it goes out of bounds. Hurst would win the match for the Miners 6-4, 6-4. Number 3 singles now, Nagani's Luke Skews near side, Menominee's Mitchell Bourchet far side. Bourchet would win the battle in this match, but the Warsaw co-UP champions as Nagani and Menominee finished the day on top of the leaderboards. For state champs, I'm Sam Ali.
All right, to celebrate our 500th episode and Michigan weather finally heating up, we're taking a look back at some of the best state champ celebrations, cooling down with a splashdown.
I'm here with John Holt pitching no-hitter against University Liggett.
We want you. We are LTU, Lawrence Technological University, and as one of the nation's best schools for engineering, architecture, and technology, we don't want just anybody. We want students who are curious and driven. Students who want to change the world through technology, science, and design. So if you believe that possible is everything, we want you at LTU.
And that's why you always get a better deal at Sarah Chevrolet in Southfield.
Hey, how'd you do that?
What? That? Oh, that's our studio audience. They let us know when something important happens. Like these Lee specials.
Get bonus tag specials like this cruise for just $99 a month for 24 months. Or lease the all-new Malibu as low as $129 a month and no payments for 90 days.
Hi, guys.
Why do they like Kelly so much?
I don't know. I heard she's getting her own show.
Fundraising should be fresh, flavorful, and simple. We have the perfect solution at Hungry Howie's, Doughraiser. Your nonprofit organization can sell paper pizza certificates that your customers can redeem for one medium pizza at participating Hungry Howie's locations. Go to doughraiser.com to learn about, sign up for, and order everything Doughraiser. Request a Doughraiser kit for your group today. Your next fundraiser comes with flavored crust. Welcome to Hungry Howie's Doughraiser.
Welcome back to State Champs' 500th show. From a late summer weekend in 2002 to an early summer weekend here in 2016, State Champs has always been there. Let me tell you, it's been quite a journey.
If you really think about it, 500 shows in television, that's a rarity. For nearly 15 years, State Champs has endured. Why? You're looking at it. Anyone who's played high school sports knows it's quite often the greatest time in your life. We continue to celebrate that 40 weeks a year. Lou Battanti created the whole concept of the show and secured the show's foundation. Matt Battanti previously ran the day-to-day operations. There was a lot riding on the very first show.
I was up all night long editing that first show. I watched it nervously, felt like it was a good product. When it actually aired for the very first time the next Sunday at 12 noon, I was in a room with about 70 high school kids. And when it happened there and then watching the reactions, I didn't even look at the TV. I was just watching faces of all the kids. Right. And it was a hit. And I knew we had something really special.
Despite State Champs pumping out great shows year after year, including taking home a few Michigan Emmys, by 2011, the show was on life support, as was the economy. Lou is retired now, but believed we had something special. As the new president and securing investment, we got the backing needed and tremendous support from Lawrence Tech, who really believed in what we were doing. So we moved on campus, have a state-of-the-art facility, and have grown big time.
If you really look at our history, we've grown from state champs to other high school sports shows, Beyond Sports, Legends, Extra Point, Recruiting Day.
History aside, it's all about the future. Our expansion plans have no limits. Okay, maybe not global domination, but our mission is to grow state champs throughout the Great Lakes states. Look out, Indiana and Wisconsin, you're first up. You think we can't do it?
There's no doubt in my mind that we'll be able to duplicate the same dynamic and shows that we have here in the other states. If we keep one thing on our plate at all times, it's about the kids, and it's about having a mission that we cover all the sports, guys and girls, and we try to show the best stories.
A total of 5 Emmys now, with perhaps some more coming in just a few weeks. The bottom line is that our unique model doesn't cater to just the big sports. We love all sports. We love every single community we get a chance to interact with, small or large. We are proud to be a Michigan-owned business with Michigan workers promoting Michigan. We've come a long way, baby.
I believe we'll be here in another 10 years, another 500 shows. So it's been a great ride. But I'm getting ready to retire again. So, man, you want to take over again?
We're just getting started. From our family to yours, I'm Lauren Plant.
Sarah Chevrolet is proud to recognize the hardworking people in the communities they serve with the Sarah Chevrolet Community Awards. June's Athlete of the Month Award was given to Carl Kaufman, a senior baseball pitcher from Brother Rice High School. Carl is a leader on and off the field as a 2015 All-State and Dream Team member, while also giving back to the community through Gleaners Detroit and more. Carl will continue his baseball career at the University of Michigan next year and is likely to be drafted in the 2016 MLB Draft. Sarah Chevrolet is happy to have him as the Athlete of the Month.
Carl, on behalf of Sarah Chevrolet, I'd like to present you with the Student Athlete of the Month. Congratulations and thank you.
Thank you.
Well, we wouldn't have made it to 500 episodes without all the amazing reporters we've had on State Champs. Let's take a look back at everyone who's helped us get here. Kyle, Kaliana, Ryan S., Ruthie, Annie, Kiara, Rosalie, Shelby, Lauren, Ashley R., David, Justin, Ashley S., Kevin, Brad, Matt, Lacey, Sarah, Melissa, Tanis, Donna, Jerry. And last but not least, Ryan Terpstra has moved over from the west side of the state to here in Metro Detroit. He's still part of the company and he'll be making some appearances here on State Champs. Stay with us.
There's an old saying, you can never have too many officials. The age of the average official is 52 and getting older all the time. We're constantly recruiting new people, younger people to join us. After you register with the MHSAA, look on the website to find an officials association near you. They'll put you in a position to succeed as an official. We all learned a lot from high school sports, and officiating is a great way to give back to the game. There's help wanted, just whistle.
Touchdown, Pelicans.
Hungry Howie's founded Flavored Crust, but how can we really own flavor?
One word, brand extensions. Behold, butter cheese toothpaste.
You actually made a tube of toothpaste.
Not just one, check it. I got sesame, Asiago cheese, onion.
Where are these coming from?
I've got an intern.
Really?
Hey, order online and get a meal deal for any size budget.
Hungry? Howie's!
We're the Cronin Law Firm, bringing more to the table. When we sit down together, we share our expertise. You've got a legal problem, we know you need relief. Advice that you can trust, that's what people come to us. We're the Cronin Law Firm, bringing more to the table.
Get ready! The high school football season will be here before you know it! The Detroit Sports Commission Prep Kickoff Classic returns to Midtown Detroit and the campus of Wayne State University August 25th through the 27th. Michigan's premier season-opening prep football event, now in its 12th year, will welcome 7 games over 3 days and feature the state's top teams and players. Log on to DetroitSports.org for more information.
Time for this week's look inside Lawrence Tech. Let's check out the latest recruits in men's basketball.
Well, we do a lot of engineering programs at the high school I go to, and I wanted to look for a school that could pair up with that's Project Lead the Way, and LTU is one of the first ones that popped up.
I met the coaches and the players, and that's what really won me over here, is that they, all the guys, all the players, all the coaches, they're nice, you know, and that's what I really wanted. I want to build a relationship with these guys.
I was really interested in the architecture program here. Been pretty good from what I know of, and then knowing that there's a basketball team here, I was asked the coach if he was interested, and luckily he was.
For more information, head to LTUathletics.com.
What's happening, State Champs fans? Jerry Mack here with your drive for the title. Macomb, Dakota, top-ranked in the state. They're taking on Utica Ford in a district final matchup. The Cougars coming in at 33-2 with two on and two out. The freshman Corbin Heisen smacks one to right field. Dakota led 8-0 after busting this one open in the fifth. The Cougars added to their total in the sixth. Claire Hamlin shoots one to right. That scores Olivia Patton. The very next batter, Samantha Bunk, drives one back up the middle. Katie Popko scores from second, and that would be all she wrote. Macomb, Dakota, impressive in this one. The Cougars took this one by a final of 10-0. From districts to regionals, we move on to girls lacrosse. Division II action is Farmington Hills Mercy squared off with Walled Lake Northern. That's Farmington Hills Mercy in maroon. Nice job by the Marlins cycling the ball here. The patience pays off as Sierra Lopez finds Lily Blake. The senior finds her window, buries it home as Mercy jumped out to a 5-2 lead. Late in the first half, Northern finding some offensive rhythm. Mackenzie Majorano with a nice feed to a slashing Morgan Avery. Avery top shelf. The Knights able to cut it to 1 heading into the half. But in the second half, Mercy would start to pull away. Blake with the clean win off the draw, quickly pushes the ball upfield to find Evie Druker in stride, corner pocket. Mercy raises some hardware as the Marlins take this one by a final of 14-8. Boys regional final up next. We peek in on Division I as Detroit Country Day met up with the Brighton Bulldogs. Country Day going for their second straight regional title. Tim Stebbins fires at home here as the Yellow Jackets got out to a 5-0 lead. Brighton wouldn't go away though. Bulldogs held scoreless in the first, but not in the second. Drew Billig fights off his man and beats the goalie upstairs. The deficit was cut to 3. But that's as close as Country Day would allow it to get. Nice feed down low to Cameron Barr. The senior wouldn't be denied. Country Day over Brighton, 15-9. Girls tennis state finals taking place this weekend. We checked in at the Midland Tennis Center to bring you coverage from Division I. Quick look in at the featured match of the day. Anika Tarlagata in the near court from West Bloomfield taking on Raven Neely from Grosse Pointe South. The freshman takes this one in two sets, 6-1, 6-4. Last year's runner-up Midland Dow and the defending champs from Northville, the heavy favorites in 2016. These two teams appearing in 6 of the 8 finals matches. The top-seeded one doubles pair from Midland Dow dominant in their match, winning in straight sets. Dow victorious in all 3 doubles matchups against Northville. Caroline Szabo and Shanoli Kumar doing battle in the 2 singles flight. After winning the first set 6-2, the big serve from Szabo seals the deal for the Chargers. Szabo wins this one 6-2, 6-3. This year belongs to Midland Dow as the Chargers win their first title since 2009. For State Champs, I'm Jerry Mack.
Tom back here with another edition of our Softball Player of the Year Award, sponsored by Total Softball. Donnie Dreher here for our another segment. And we want to remind everybody that voting ends this Monday at 11:59 p.m. Next week's show, we will have our 4 finalists. We want to talk about some of the underclassmen that perhaps you don't know about and we haven't talked much about that'll be in the running for next year's award. Donnie, take it away.
Yeah, Tom, in addition to the 8 underclassmen that have been on our list through the course of this year, Maya Kipmiller is having a monster year at Midland High School. You got Renee Hoffman, a great pitcher from Clinton. Shaden Knapp from Vicksburg, a fast leadoff hitter shortstop. Madison Jones, power hitter from Romeo High School. Another great leadoff hitter, Sophie Van Ecker from Mercy. Alexis Taube, a power hitting shortstop from Mattawan. Abby Niehaus, another great player from Grass Lake. So those are just some of the great kids that we're looking at, underclassmen that are looking to get on that list for next year.
That's going to be it for this week. Next week, we'll have our final 4.
Here at State Champs, we love celebrating high school athletics and the athletes that make them special. Tons of athletes you've seen here first on State Champs are now in the pros. Let's check it out.
Camp is Metro Detroit's original Chrysler, Dodge, Jeep, and Ram dealer, and we're still making the best deals every day. During the Drive and Discover event, lease a Ram Crew Cab 4x4 as low as $217 a month, or a Jeep Grand Cherokee Laredo for just $259. Celebrating 25 years of giving customers a superior buying experience, that's Neff Camp on Telegraph Road in Redford.
Neff Camp, Metro Detroit's original. Neff Camp, Neff Camp.
We want you.
We are Lawrence Technological University, and we don't want just anyone.
We want the brainiacs, visionaries, geniuses, and game changers. We want the students who will change the world through technology, science, business, and design.
So if you're ready to explore your possibilities,
we want you at LTU.
Lawrence Tech, possible is everything.
With 14 schools in the Big Ten, you get a full 40% more of everything you love at no extra charge. Now that's our kind of conference. Meijer, proud sponsor of the Big Ten and more.
Welcome back to State Champs. Welcome back to show number 500. And this guy, Tom Markowski, has been with us since the beginning. Now, we all know he's older, slower, much grouchier than he used to be, but we still love him.
I still have some hair on my head.
All right. Let's go in the dugout and have Tom comment on a few of the coaches who are being inducted into the Baseball Coaches Hall of Fame this year. You see the list on your screen, and frankly, all of these guys deserve it.
Yeah, great group here. Dan Cimini out of Grosse Pointe Woods University Liggett. Really built a strong program out of a small school, won some state titles. Great job by Dan. We're going to Bob Riker, Birmingham Brother Rice, 5 Catholic League titles in a row. And also on the west side from Oak Ridge, you have Brandon Berry, 26 years at Oak Ridge. Got to the semifinals in 2009, lost to Blissfield. Also won regional titles in 2011, 2014.
Yeah, congratulations. So you gonna stick around for the next 500?
Maybe.
Main event time, ladies and gentlemen. More state championship coverage, and we go to the west side of the state for coverage of the Division I and Division II boys and girls track and field state finals. Baldwin Middle School in Hudsonville, the site of the 2016 Division I track and field state finals. Rainy conditions, but let's fly, starting with the boys. 100 dash, East Kentwood Junior Kantz Myers ran the fastest 100 of any D1 regional. Middle of your screen takes the tape. Kantz only had the 4th fastest time in the 200, but not here, setting a new 200 D1 finals meet record. Let's head to the field. Oxford's Connor Bandel came in the reigning champ in both the shot put and here in the discus. He set all meet records in both events. Incredible. Back to the track, to the 800 meter. Oak Park taking center stage. Cameron Cooper cruises to victory. They win just one race, but racked up points all day, and the Oak Park boys win their first track state championship in 44 years. Let's go to the girls now. We start with the 3200. Farmington's Maddie Trevison going to cap her senior year in style. She took 5th in this event a year ago, state champ in 2016. To the sprints we go, 100 dash. East Kentwood, Sakaya Bracey, some kind of runner. 8 individual titles over her first 3 seasons. Middle screen in the neon green, another gold. She took the long jump as well. Now the Oak Park girls came in the back-to-back state champs. Could they three-peat? Breaking records in the 4x100 relay and all meet MHSAA finals record. The Oak Park ladies would not be denied. Dorian Coleman will be first to the finish line in the 800. Oak Park girls and boys sweep the team titles. To Zeeland now for Division II. Orchard Lake St. Mary's are defending boys team champs. 100 dash, junior KJ Hamler came in with the top time. Middle screen, gold. In the 1600, Algonac's Morgan Beetlescomb looking to defend his title? He would. But the Orchard Lake boys, once again, back-to-back state champs. To the girls, 400 relay.
Lansing Waverly took ninth a year ago, but clearly on their game this year. Sophomore Trishelle Roberts wins for the Warriors, 200 dash, and Carl Nairport's Zoe Ebby, the defending title holder, middle screen, she does it again. We wrap with the 100 hurdles, Harper Woods, Chandler Park representing, more importantly, Jada Steele. But it would be Lansing Waverly winning the team's first state title in school history. The main event is sponsored by Meijer.
Congrats to all of our brand new state champions, and thanks for checking out our 500th episode. Two more weeks before our summer vacation, tons of state finals in between.
For sure, and before we go, we've assembled what we believe are the top five state championship moments in state champs history. We'll talk to you next week. Enjoy.
2007 Division II Hockey State Finals. Grosse Pointe South and Muskegon Mona Shores battled to a draw for three periods. In OT, Tim Shield makes history. First hockey state title for the Blue Devils.
Awesome.
2015 Division I Track and Field State Finals. Grand Blanc superstar distance runner Grant Fisher smashes the 1600 state record by 7 seconds. Fisher ran a 4-minute mile. Here's a shout out to the small towns. 2009 Class B Volleyball State Finals. North Branch wins their first state title in any sport, and the emotion of the moment got the best of them.
We've worked so hard for all of this, and like everything just finally came together and we finally won a state championship. It's awesome.
2005 Class D Boys Basketball State Finals. What a great game this was between Belair and Detroit Rogers. 3 seconds left and down three. Rogers freshman Eric Evans steals the inbound pass and makes an impossible shot. Rogers wins their third straight state title. Here it is, 2015 Division II Football State Finals. Detroit King and Lowell duked it out all game long. Lowell leading, final play of the game, King with one last shot. Donnie Corley, Donnie touchdown, King state champs. And that's our top five state championship moments in state champs history. State champs is presented by Lawrence Technological University. Possible is everything. Sarah Chevrolet, the low payment people. Visit us at lowpayment.cars. Meijer, your destination for sporting goods and equipment. And Hungry Howie's Dough Raiser, your next fundraiser comes with flavored crust.